about chimpanzees and humans. I was highly dependent on their precise sequences. The similarity between chimpanzee and human sequences would not be surprising. They could be performing the same function, requiring the same sequence of both genomes. As an example, pseudogene in the beta globe, a cluster of genes in humans, shows evidence of similar sequence similarity within between the humans and chimpanzee populations. The similarity is not due to protein loading, but it is through regulation of developmental change in the beta chromosome interactions. Syntheid refers to how well chromosomal sequences from different species align with one another, how similar the arrangement of genes along their chromosome is. Skipping over, thus it is possible that any similarity in gene order might be a function of both chimps and humans need. If the sequence similarity is due to function, then it need not indicate common ancestry. Synonymous coding use of complicated subject and then skip over this dimension if you're interested. The book is there. Chromosomal fusion when two human genomes are compared. Our chromosome 2 appears to be a fusion of two chimpanzee chromosomes. The argument is made that this demonstrates a common ancestry with chimpanzee. However, the junction where the supposed fusion took place is not really typical in telomeric set sequences. Telomeres are special sequences found in the other chromosomes. Instead, degenerate sequences are found. Sequences found elsewhere in the genome but not associated with breaks or fusions. The designer is a deceiver. This argument goes something like this. If there's an intelligent designer, then how do you make it look like things are wrong? That makes him the deceiver. And actually, that's probably the single biggest argument. There's a logical flaw here as well. It is stated as that things look like they evolve by natural processes. But things do not look like they evolve. As this is continued with that paragraph. As has been shown, many good reasons to believe things were designed. There are also many examples from the design of larger scale structures like the eye, or like an eye, or what's called the eye, or 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 the eye, by meeting the accounts to leave the denialability from them. The appearance is there. You can't get away from it. Of course, G.G. Simpson, the telephone, this is the telephone, the typewriter. It's a complex mechanism serving a particular function. Obviously, it's made by your algorithms in mind. The machine was designed to work with only certain algorithms.
Humans and mice were 50% similar. That cast is a lot of argument, not totally.
is that there are areas in humans and in mice that are virtually identical, even though they don't code the protein, and their non-coding function is not understood. And they wish to scratch their head, and sometimes they'll say that they must have some function, because otherwise they couldn't have preserved this similarity over literally hundreds of millions of years. So there must be some function, we just don't know what it is. Double Y. They tend to disproportionately populate our chimpanzees.